Okay, so today what I want to do is I want to finish up like I want to convert the state data to also be like imported and exported to and from files. Or rather, I don't even have the exporter finished right now. Like I'm not even exporting stuff at all. I don't even have it compiling. It's probably broken. Yeah, okay. So what I'm going to do is get the exporter back online and finish it up and then start to make it into a proper separate system that I can export this stuff easily from here into files and then I can re-import it. And then get all the, like, just remove the last of the hard-coded state data here. So, first part, add this to be compiled. Entity, and then exports after that. See what breaks on that one. This is using of the older, yes. Because group data is from here now. Inside of here, what's it called? We still have importers. Do I want to get it by importer or no? It's because it's group name. That's what matters. So does the index generator even have the name still? Yes, it does. Why? Whatever, I'll get it from importer. That's easy enough. We get the group and we get the group ID, which is I. Yeah. Okay. Next is dependencies to file. Wait, what was that? That was writing the. Oh, yeah. That puts it out to the file. Index generator has probably gone through a change. No, we want the libs YAML one. There you are. YAML write index generator, it's the node name, which is currently it's the root node, the data, and then we have node. We're gonna put it in. You have a void. Data. Okay. What's going on here? Groups. Do we even need to do this? Do I want to store data on a per? Ooh, yeah, that's, yeah. Because right now for this, I do want to store item and state data together in one file per entity. But I don't like this. I really don't like this. So we get indices, we're going to get the active entity list for whatever that's worth. Then we're going to write entity data, which takes in ID and state pools, not resource pools. Returns a YAML node right now. Then we do groups. Yeah. Okay. After we've added this stuff, we want to add it here. Export state. State. I'm going to put it into, was it data slash, or just like root directory test export. That. Amazing. We put in. Set state. Resources. Let's see what terrifying things are going to happen. If it exists and is there. Okay, yeah. Okay, no, we don't need this. Actually, I can keep this as it is right now. Okay. What's in here? Dependencies or none. Index data is that. We have state data for these things. Ooh, yeah, that's a problem, isn't it? Because entities and resources are sharing the same thing. Same ID set. All right, well, at the very least, these last ones have something real. So this is the camera. This is the render triangle, and this will be at 4 plus 4. This will be the model that's animated model with mesh. And all this stuff. Yeah, I'm surprised it doesn't actually recognize this as YAML. One thing I'm missing is, oh, I don't have node names and stuff. Or editor names. That's something we are not exporting at all. So what will this be? This will be pass that in. That here. We'll be putting it in here. We don't need resource pools anymore. Ooh, do we? Need the name map at least. Okay, oh, I need to write out the ID stuff as well. Well, It's best practice. So ID. Oh, this will also require, would it require? No, it wouldn't. It doesn't require group translations. Not for, no. So. I need the functionality for the editor name, which is just super simple. Yaml editor name HP. Yaml read. Require, no, I don't really need this. Not really, not yet, not right now, no. No, keep it simple. I already have YAML parsing, so we'll just do if p. What editor name, right? Okay. YAML write entity? What are you missing? The editor name, right. We got here. Nope, and nope. Nothing happened. Interesting. Really? We go down here, right? We're here. No, we don't. We skip this. Why? Why do we skip this? Do, 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 do. failed to create directory. Oh, yeah, okay. Wait, it should have just gone through this. Yeah, whatever. Nope, nothing happened. Okay, so the directory exists. Gotta go through that. Mm-hmm. Okay. We're just going to remove everything in the YAML path to start with. So that should give us the ability to come back through to this point. Okay, we're there. Da-da-da. Name is empty, so we don't do it. That's fine. Mm-hmm. Oh, it's down here, right. Burn through them all. That failed. Okay. The index ID's there. Camera, render try, render mesh. I don't have the ability to import this name, do I? YAML importer. I just import state data, state pools, but I don't actually have for the editor name. Thinking of splitting up the entity and resource ID rather than using types is to have separate IDs entirely. Otherwise, I have all these considered as that separate index generators for entities and resources and what have you may make more sense in the long run. Okay. Regardless of that, let's finish this up. The export's basically going through almost everything. Just okay, faux YAML parsing. Just include all these. Is saving the armature state valuable? It probably will be one day, but for now it's not. It's not even an animation. Wrong order. Time, okay. Come back to entity. We also need to write it out if it exists. Well, no, that's what we did there. Now we need to read it if it exists. Let's see if it's output here. Illegal instruction. All right. Return the node. Thank you. And return armature state. Animation one. Okay. Let's copy these three, bring them up here, into here. So the idea here is that these three are going to become actually, we'll come to this point. We'll see if we have the data, first of all. So we've already imported from state. I'm expecting this to just fall apart right away. Maybe not. Okay, so the data is there. And then if I was to, let's say, remove these again, then it craps out, right? Yeah. Get rid of that. We don't want it. Minutes. Okay, we'll call it a nice short episode where we swap things around a little bit. To be functional. Capable. But that's only the state data. I don't have the resources done. Okay, resources. YAML write resource. do it in line here somewhere. I'm not sure if I want to go through that way or just write resources. Do I just write all resources? It may just be better to just go through and just do them all. You know what? Okay. Yeah. So that's what we're going to do. No. How do we do this? How are we going to do this? We just iterate through the resources. Can I get the full list of resources? Can I iterate through them right now? I might still have that temporary stuff. Yeah, get data vector right there. That's what I'm doing. It's just pointers, right? Yeah, it's just pointers. So we're going to... I need to get the entity name, ID, actually. I'm going to determine the name. How do I do that? Export group. State data. That's written here, is it? Where do I determine the name? Oh, below, yes. Okay. Okay. How do I want to go about doing this? Okay, I guess we can just do like the this foe res YAML export void YAML write definition, where it takes in turns a YAML node. Okay, what do we have? We have the data subnode. Split it on the right. I can see exactly what do I have. File name. Then I have animations. Oh no. This requires data that I just don't have. Oops. All right, I'm going to end it here while I figure out what exactly, like, I have the data for the create info and then I just discard it. I don't have it anymore. I have the data I've imported from it, but like I actually need the original import create info type data. And I don't carry that around because I don't, generally I don't need it. I really don't. Unless I'm trying to re-export it, like right now. Okay, so create info. I need to get the create. I need to keep the create info. Whichever it may be. Data write lock would include some public info. I want to make a do I have a memory? No. Going to the armature loader, right? That's just the YAML side. Set into this. CreateInfo star that allows us to keep that. Then up here in YAML, we can write it. Info armature. Okay, we can, yeah, we take that in. Do. Go to the armature right side. So in data node, we're going to write out basically what? Just these two things and then the animation. So. For animation stuff. which is the animation node, which is a separate one underneath. That go up. So animation names. first of all, we got the file name. I need to have it first. Subnode. Okay, we'll just kind of do this subnode. I'm just going to add each of these. So YAML. So each of these is a subnode, right? So if we add all these. Animation list. It's animation node. We put that onto animation list node. Then at the end of that, animation file node. Just going to be YAML write required. File name, iterator, no, file. Names equals that. Then at the end of it, push back. At the end of it, data node, animations, Okay. rolling back into export. Is it export or? Okay, yeah. So we need the info for iterator dot createInfo dot get if, oh, rather. Okay, we got out node, then afterwards, rather, iterator get ID. So we've got path, group, name, resource pool, okay. Path, group, name, resource pool. This is because I broke it, didn't I? Did I? Okay. Resources? No resources. Wah-wah. Not even that either, actually. Cute. Imagine it broke in here somewhere. So let's find out. Oh, right. I added it, but I didn't actually set it in as part of the loader. Ooh, I don't actually have it loaded by this point either. Okay. Okay, what I'm going to do then is I need to move the export to be at the end of the application for the moment. Up here. Okay. Oh, E8000C. Not quite what I'm looking for. I mean, that's a persistent set, so I'm actually not doing the persistent set check. Actually, I haven't even changed up the export to properly use the new name convention that I have, did I? That's decimal. I need to change that up. Whatever. What's in here? Data file name. Da, 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 da. And that should match this almost. We've got the data. We just need to print out the type, version, editor name. Okay. Iterator get ID for the current node, root node. Nope, nothing. No change, which is odd. Oh, because I'm overriding it. Need to change that. Okay, that's index ID. I don't have the name map. The name mapping. I'm guessing I'm not loading that in correctly. It should make sense, I guess. At least the index ID. In type and version. I need to change that up. And I don't have the type of version information. Okay, well, I'll add it manually for the moment. What? Oh, it thinks it's a char star. Yeah, okay, that makes sense. It's not. Don't want to do that. Or can I do string view? I can do that. Or can I? No. That's actually something I want to do then. I want to add that. I can't do that. It doesn't accept it. Okay. Add another one for string view parsing. So we're just gonna subtype it, basically calling these guys. That. String view that. T type. Okay, yeah, type. Actually, no, this is no. Just convert to the string at the call point. Okay. Armature version 1. Why can't it determine like that this is a YAML? It's because of VOX. Whatever. We're missing one more line. Which is the editor name, which we're not grabbing yet. So let's fix that. Would I do that? It'd have to be part of it, like it's something that's going to have to go through. Or would it? No. It wouldn't have to. Not necessarily. So if I'm reading a resource. Only if we succeed out of here, do we want to add it to the editor name map? Think. I mean, basically be the same for this as well. We want to try. If, okay. Yeah. Actually, I can just do it regardless. Yes, this is a bit more difficult if I'm trying to get a resource from that instead. Well, not necessarily. Export if if we have it. The importer doesn't quite have. Okay, yeah, here. There we go. editor names. Resources. This is good. This is good. This is good. All right. Then we need to expand it to the other type. So this was what, armature, right? Yeah. Create info, image loader, if we get to this point, same thing for image. It's a private of this guy. Yeah, okay. What is it? Test image, right? It's just file. some emergencies happening just down the street. Let me pause this one. No sirens. Okay, well, with that stuff sorted out, I finished up with the images, and now I'm working on materials. I've got this new... That's writing. Okay, this is the public side. Create material. This is the old thing. So we got the definition. We're gonna have write material definition. So include. Or rather, what I'm going to do is I'm just going to get this stuff. So this is the shader declaration. What was the shader declaration? I mean, this is shader public. But it's just the ID right now. Yeah, it's just the ID. That is fragment descriptor. How do I grab that in? I have all this stuff. I only have the create info with me. Okay, then how do I get this out though? Into I'm loading it. Okay, that's not quite what I was hoping for. Imagine this would also be the same for several others. Okay. Back to export. I need to add create info to the material type. Okay, looks like Clang D decided to fall over, so let's reload it all. Right, let's see how this turns out. We have 1, 2, and 3 materials. Let's see what they turn out, if they turn out. So that's the armature. Okay, so it's these ones. 03 resource. Okay, not this one. Not this one. Is it this one? 9. Okay, fragment shader 9. Graphics data. With index ID being 3, the material, type material version 1. Okay. So then we get number 4. 11:15. Four, material two, material one, okay. 7:05, mesh material, mesh. Okay, materials there. That fixes up the last one. Let's add these as we've got them so far and move on to the next one. So next will be mesh. Okay, what do we have for this? We have three types, three possible types. Ooh, crap. Yeah, that's right. We got, One, two, three. Yeah, okay, so it doesn't, so it's one of them. If that's the case, then we do YAML required. It doesn't do anything, actually. Okay, back to export. Write mesh definition, which is that. I need to include the file for it. Image, here we go. Okay, I don't have this. Makes sense. And I wouldn't want to have this. 13 test mesh, yes. And then 14 sphere, tower test mesh 2. Okay. Shader and vertex descriptor. Okay, what's going on in here? Right, yes, because all the shaders are still exporting that still. Reading in the definition is the graphics data and that. Yeah, I need this to. All right. Not entirely. I need to pass in graphics session information. If I want to get that shader information back. Unless I'm going willing to. Okay, for the moment, we'll just manually pass it through. So I need okay, we come through to shader public. It's writing this stuff to a file, which it really shouldn't be doing. Instead, we want to. Oh, yeah. Wrong shader names. Okay, so let's start with number 6. Mesh bone, graphics data, built-in project. Yep. 6, yes. No, wrong export type. Okay, now it's correct. Let's go to 7. Graphics data is blank. Index ID 7. Mesh. Shader. UV to cut frag color. That's correct for this one. 8. It's a mesh. 9. It's a shader again. 9. The shader. Shader 1. UV to color frag. Okay. 10, 10, 10, 10, 10. At least vertex descriptors. Which is also going to have Vulkan or graphics data in the back. Hmm. So what exactly is in the saving of this? Reading, writing. Cheat just a little bit. Let's make sure I can write it, and then I can reread it, and then I'll start fixing up the old scoping and refine and iterate on it. Because yeah, these last two are kind of a mess, messy hacky nonsense. I do have that, so Okay. Okay. Looks like I can export basically everything. Now I need to. Okay, first of all, let's fix up the export name convention. So what's the name? What's the name? I need to get the ID. Split. No, I don't want to do that. Something like this. ID, and then I have okay, if get group out of the ID, that's if. Not equal persistent. Group to value. Group value. Then we need to add it to the beginning. String stream. it's basically the same thing as this. Const expression. The editor name. Name's not empty. ID to file name of ID P name map resource. Oh, it's plus that. Okay, hold on. Back up. What's going on? Hmm. It's not quite in order, but it'll be more compact than actual numbers. This will be its group, index, editor name. Then we'd want to do the same thing in state data, right? Yeah. Okay. Extra brace. All right. Let us see what happens if we just replace everything inside of data, state the data A, resources. Just copy all this. Good. Very good. So the state data is all together. I gotta figure out if I want to re-split up resource IDs and entity IDs. You just have separate ID types entirely. And if I'm going to do that, I'm probably going to want some strong typing between them as well. Or strong typing. And that's kind of a C++ thing. I mean, they're basically UN32s. Whatever. It's exporting, which is what I like. So I think I'll actually call it a day on this one. Or for the moment. Yeah, several hours. and fragile. Call it there. Cheers.